Monday Morning House Calls, sponsored by UK HealthCare.
Welcome back inside Mountain News this morning. Today we have Dr. Bakari with us. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
And this morning we are talking about atrial fibrillation. What does that mean?
So atrial fibrillation is an arrhythmia. It's an rhythm of the heart, which is always normal rhythm. What happens is instead of heart beating normally, you have a heart beating irregularly, mm-hmm. which is the heart rhythm, it becomes irregular. Mm-hmm. And it does two things with the heart. It makes the heart beat fast, and some people feel that if you have fluttering in the heart, and it puts the patient at risk of a stroke.
Mm-hmm. Can you feel this irregularity when it's happening?
Not all the time.
Okay.
Some patients do, some patients don't.
Okay.
And that's why a lot of time atrial fibrillation is occult, which is basically asymptomatic. Patients come in feeling fine, and we find it on our examination.
Okay, well are there any symptoms then?
So symptoms of atrial fibrillation, as I mentioned, some patients, when the heart beats fast or irregularly, they feel that. They feel mm-hmm. that as palpitations, or fluttering in the heart.
Mm-hmm.
The atrial fibrillation does two things to the heart. It makes the heart beat fast, and you feel that. It also puts the patient at risk of having a stroke.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes the first presenting symptom of atrial fibrillation is a stroke or a mini stroke.
That's very serious. So
absolutely.
How is it diagnosed?
So it's diagnosed based on EKG, on physical examination. When we examine somebody, we see, the heart is not beating regularly.
Right.
Something's going on. We do an EKG, and it's a very simple way of diagnosing atrial fibrillation.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we have to do some more testing, like a Holter monitor, where patients wear a monitor for 24 hours.
Mm-hmm.
We monitor all their heartbeats for 24 hours, or some other testing needs to be done. But usually an EKG can easily diagnose atrial fibrillation.
But if someone's not feeling any symptoms, then how would they know to come in to get tested?
Absolutely, and that's the whole idea behind this intervention, is basically for people to gain awareness about it.
Okay.
People need to know that atrial fibrillation is a serious thing,
mm-hmm.
is a serious problem that puts them at risk of a heart problem,
mm-hmm.
and basically stroke. And they if they check their blood pressure regularly at home, sometimes the blood pressure machine, because it can also check heart rate,
right.
that can also mention there's something wrong and to seek medical care.
Okay.
If the heart rate is irregular, the blood pressure machine will give an error, and that would be a sign for a couple of patients. That's how they've diagnosed atrial fibrillation in my case.
Wow. All right. So if someone is not feeling any symptoms, how often should they come in just to be checked?
So basically in somebody who doesn't have any symptoms and just wants to be checked for an atrial fibrillation, they need to have a thorough examination by their primary care doctor. They can easily do that, or a cardiologist can do that.
Mm-hmm.
And if they're doing okay, the primary care doctor will also check their blood pressure, check their heart rate, you know, look at other things. And if everything is okay, then they just need to have yearly evaluation, yearly physical, and that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
If they have any symptoms, of course, any kind of symptoms, then they need to seek medical care at that
mm-hmm.
time.
Really quickly, how would someone be treated if they are diagnosed?
So if a patient is diagnosed with atrial fibrillation, there are multiple treatments for them. There's some treatments which are directed to restore normal rhythm. There are some treatments which are directed to prevent the complications,
mm-hmm.
which is basically stroke.
Right.
And there are some treatments which are directed to let the patient be in atrial fibrillation, live with it,
mm-hmm.
but we control their heart, we manage their symptoms.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Bakari.
You're welcome.
We'll have more Mountain News in just a moment.